Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
A reading from Mark. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it,' and will send it back here immediately." They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Even those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Let us pray. O God of mercy and might, in the mystery of the passion of your Son, you offer your infinite life to the world. Gather us around the cross of Christ and preserve us until the resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Greetings. This beginning of the holiest of weeks, in the name of our impassioned and soon to rise Lord, the Son of our faithful God and our pioneer of the faith. Amen.
Amen.
If now in this second passion tide of the season of COVID, we are feeling what I'll call a temporal disruption, a sense of time just totally broken over and laid over itself in many folds. This week we add to that, quite frankly, a kind of temporal compression, as we usually do in this high liturgical time of the year. We have come in now to our Jerusalem. We have processed through the Jaffa Gate, as it were, the eastern side of Jerusalem's walls, and we have entered now into the heart of the city. At the same time that we entered, if we remember that we are with the people of God from ages of old, and all time is compressing upon us, that even 2,021 years ago or so, give or take some years, at the very same time that we entered with Christ and welcomed Christ in this grand parade into the holy city, from the western side and re-entered to return to their government offices, the emperor's representatives, dressed in high and noble garb on high steeds, with great fanfare militarily for themselves as well. You can understand the counterpoint and the statement that is made. And we soon now understand too that as we take our place with all the people of God in this great and real drama of passion and redemption, that we will hear soon the many roles of the people that we all play year in and year out, no matter the temporal disruption, no matter the temporal compulsion and compression. And so now we come, indeed, all too quickly, as would happen with the fickle parts of human being, to challenge and suffering, to acknowledging the reality of the passion of scourging and murderous death. It is the responsibility of the arrogantly powerful and all those who at one time or another support such bullying, lynching activity. We of all people, with full confidence in the faithfulness of God, because ultimately that's what this week is all about, we of all people should know this truth, that true faith, as Shusaku Endo wrote in a different manner, true faith should be able to respond to the dark melodies, the faulty and hideous sounds that echo from the heart of human beings. So we are going to look plainly and honestly on the violence wrought against God, acknowledge our complicity in it, and find in such an objective doing that God is faithful to us as God is faithful to God's Son, Jesus the Christ, and so in being faithful nevertheless to Christ and us, God will save us, being as we are, notwithstanding. True faith should be able to respond to the dark melodies, the faulty and hideous sounds that echo in the hearts of human beings. And so now let us, with all due sincere reflection and commitment of memory, look upon the acts of God's creation of human beings, and above all that, the acts of God in Jesus Christ, in finally the most consequential week, we claim, in human history.
A reading from Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with the word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered him, "You say so." Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak and after twisting some thorns into a crown, he put it on him, and he began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull, and they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified 2 bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "Aha, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross now, so that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also taunted him.
When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he is calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was God's son." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Christ.
Thank you.
celebrate the anniversary of their baptism this week. Tom, Nicholas, Lizzie, Jim, Weldon, Anita, Kelly, Colin, Larry, Dilsha, Pam, John, Kate, Landon, Maribel, and Marilyn, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. As with your incarnation and your ministry on your entry into Jerusalem, counterpointed by empire and the arrogant powerful, you came among us in Jesus as a suffering servant. Give your church humility. Redeem your people from pride and the certainty that we always know your will. Heal us and empower us to confess Christ crucified. And by bringing us yet closer to his passion and death, prepare us even more deeply to be your representatives of resurrection to all the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In creation, life springs from death. Redeem your creation awaiting resurrection. Restore lost habitats and endangered species. Create new possibilities for areas affected by climate change. Grant relief from natural disasters, especially those affected by this week's tornadoes. And nurture new growth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God, your Son, our brother, has given over to the powers of this world by our sin. In all nations, instruct the powerful that they would not exploit their power, but maintain justice. Sustain all whose vocation is the protection of neighbors and nations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
By your wondrous works, you show your mercy to all people in need. Bless the mission of Christian Community Service Center, our March mission offering, and pour out your spirit of joy and thanksgiving for their life-giving deeds. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
On the cross, Jesus joined all who feel forsaken. Abide with all victims of violence, and correct those who in act and policy abet violence. Defend those who are falsely accused. Console and strengthen those who are mocked or bullied. Accompany all who suffer, especially Bridget Jensen, Edith Nailapa, Peggy Johnson, and those we name in our hearts. Grant respite and renewal. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You called followers to tend Jesus' body and death. Sustain medical professionals, hospice workers, and funeral directors. Bless this congregation's ministries at time of death. those who plan and lead funerals, those who prepare meals, all who offer support in grief. Receive your love and keep close in our hearts those who have died. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You inspired the centurion to confess Jesus as your son. We praise you for the faith you have given to people of all places and times. Give us also such faith to trust the promises of baptism and with them to look with hope upon hope for the resurrection of the dead. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
beloved Son, whom you sent at this end of the ages to save and redeem us and to proclaim to us your will, he is your word inseparable from you, through whom you created all things and in whom you take delight. He is your word sent from heaven to a virgin's womb. He there took on our nature and our lot, and was shown forth as your Son, born of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary. He, our Lord Jesus, fulfilled all your will and won for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands in suffering in order to free from suffering those who trust you. He is the one who handed over to a death you freely accepted in order to destroy death, to break the bonds of the evil one, to crush hell underfoot, to give light to the righteous, to establish his covenant, and to show forth the resurrection. Taking bread and giving thanks to you, said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering then his death and resurrection, we take this bread and cup, giving you thanks that you have made us worthy to stand before you and to serve you as your priestly people. Send your Spirit upon these gifts of your church. Gather into one all who share this bread and wine. Fill us with your Holy Spirit to establish our faith in truth, that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come, all has been prepared. Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit, that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new, in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Thank you. You may be wondering why a guy with a monkey tail on his face is coming to talk to you after the church service. Well, my name is Nathan Weicker, and I wanted to get your attention. And I'm here on behalf of both CTK as a member, but also CCSC as a board member. And CCSC, of course, is our mission offering this month. But in addition, the CTK Foundation has graciously granted a $10,000 grant for CCSC. And we really want to multiply that impact through our mission offering as well. So you may know CCSC from, you know, some of the more popular programs such as Jingle Bell Express and their back to school program. But you know, we've also supported them in different ways over the last couple of years. Especially this past year, we were able to host 5 food drives, which helped CCSC feed 3 times as many people during the pandemic as in previous years. The CTK Young Professional Adults also volunteer at the food pantry every other month on the first Saturday. All are welcome to join if you'd like. But of course, that's in addition to a lot of the other programs that we continue to support and CCSC employs, such as rent and utility assistance, which was obviously critical over the last year. Martha's Way, which trains people to become housekeepers, and some new programs such as the home healthcare training program. This is in addition to all of their job training services, like JobNet has a beautiful new computer lab in the new building. I encourage you guys to go see it when you have the time. So with that, I ask you once again to make a donation and a sacrifice, just like I've sacrificed my face via shaving my beard into a monkey tail, and give a donation to CCSC. And if you don't take it from me, take it from the entire Young Professional Adults of Christ the King. Thanks. We're the Young Professional Adults of Christ the King Lutheran Church.
Please support CCSC.